follows is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st canto, 2nd chapter, text number 17, given by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded in the summer of 1966 in New York.
Sinnatam Satata Krishna Punna Shravana Kirtana Riddhantastra Vadrani Vidhunati Suhitata. Krishna, this sound, transcendental sound, Krishna means the highest pleasure. Highest pleasure. Everyone, every living being is seeking after pleasure. But he does not know how to seek pleasure. Therefore, in this material conception of life, we are being frustrated in every step for satisfying our pleasure. Because we have no information from which platform we can have pleasure. That we are discussing for the last few weeks, that we are not this body, we are consciousness. Not exactly consciousness, consciousness is the symptom of my real identity. I am pure soul, I am merged within this material body, and the modern material science, they have no trace of it. Therefore, they are sometimes misled about this understanding of the spirit soul. But the spirit soul is a fact, and everyone can understand by the presence of consciousness. Any child can understand. The consciousness is the symptom of the spirit soul. So the whole process, now we are trying from the Bhagavad Gita, is to bring one to get him on the platform of consciousness. And if we act from the platform of consciousness, then we may not be pushed again into the platform of this bodily conception. And if we can continue that platform, if we continue to act on that platform of consciousness, then at the end of this body, not even at the end of this body, even in the presence of this body, we shall be free. We shall be free from material contamination. Our spiritual life will be revived, and the result will be that in our next life after leaving this body, we shall have a full spiritual life, eternal. Spirit is described, we have already discussed all those points, that the spirit is eternal. Na hannate hannamane sarire. Even after the destruction of this body, the consciousness is not destroyed. That continues. Rather, consciousness transferred to another type of body makes me again alive to the material conception of life. That is also described in the Bhagavad Gita. Jangajana bhapi smaran loke tajatante kaleva. At the time of death, if our consciousness is pure, then it is sure that next life is not material, next life is pure spiritual life. But if our consciousness is not pure at the point of the verge of death, just leaving this body, then we have to take again this material body. That is the process going on by nature's law. We have got our finer body. This is gross body. The body which you are seeing, which I am seeing, this is gross body. Just like shirt and coat. Within your coat there is shirt, and within your shirt there is a body. Similarly, the pure soul is covered by shirt and coat. The shirt is mind, intelligence and false ego. Mind, intelligence and false ego. False ego means that the wrong conception that I am matter, I am something product of this material world. This wrong conception makes me localized. Just like, because I have taken my birth in America, therefore I think myself American. Because I have taken my birth in India, therefore I think myself as Indian. But as pure soul, I am neither Indian nor American. I am pure soul. Because this is designation. This American or Indian or German or Englishman or cats and dogs and this and that, black and white, all these are designation. Spiritual consciousness means to become free from all these designations. So that freedom is achieved when we are in constantly touch with the Supreme Spirit, Krishna. The Supreme Spirit is Krishna. So, this assembly which I'm trying to conduct is just to keep in touch constantly with Krishna. Krishna can be in constantly companion with us. Because He is omnipotent, God is omnipotent. Therefore, He can be exactly in touch with us by His words. His words and He are not different. That is omnipotency. Omnipotency means in everything relating to Krishna has the same potency. Just like here in this material world, if you want water, you are thirsty. If you want water, then this water simply saying repeatedly, water, 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 will not satisfy your thirst. Because this word has not the same potency as water itself. You require the water as it is, then your thirst will be satisfied. But in the transcendental, in the absolute world, there is no such difference. Krishna and Krishna's name and Krishna's words, and Krishna's qualities, Krishna's pastime, everything is Krishna. Some people argue that Arjuna was talking with Krishna. So, Krishna was present before him, whereas my case, Krishna is not present, so how I can get direction? That is not the fact. Krishna is present by His words. This Bhagavad Gita. Krishna, therefore, the system is, of course, here we don't find such facility, but in India, when we speak on the Bhagavad Gita or on Srimad Bhagavatam, we worship regularly with flower, with other paraphernalia required for worshipping, you see. And in the Sikh religion, they also, they have no deity, form of the deity, but they worship the book, Grantha Sam. Perhaps some of you who are acquainted with the Sikh communities, they worship this Grantha. Similarly, the Mohammedans also, they worship the Quran. And similarly, if you are Christian also, you worship Bible. So, it is a fact that Lord Jesus Christ is present by His words, Bible. Similarly, Krishna is present by His word. These personalities, either God or Son of God, who come from the transcendental world, they keep their transcendental identity without being contaminated by this material world. That is their omnipotence. We are practiced to say that God is omnipotent. Now, this is His omnipotence. Omnipotence means that He is not different from His name, from His quality, from His pastime, from His instruction, everything. Therefore, the discussion on Bhagavad Gita is as good as you are discussing certainly with Krishna. And not only that, Krishna is seated in your heart, in my heart also. Ishvara Sarvabhutana. God is situated in everyone's heart. God is not away from us. He is friendly. He is so friendly that in my repeated change of birth, He is with us. He is trying to see when we shall turn to Him. Rather, He is canvassing. He is canvassing. He is so kind that we may forget Him, but He has not forgotten us. He is with us. Just like the father never can forget the son, however the son may forget the father. That is natural. Similarly, God is the original father of everything, everybody, all living entities. We may have different bodies. That is our short coat. It has nothing to do with our real identity. Our real identity is pure soul. That pure soul is the part and parcel of the Supreme Lord. Mami Mamsa Jiva Bhuta. You'll find in Bhagavad Gita. And that part and parcel of the Supreme Lord is encased in this material body. And you'll find in Bhagavad Gita that the Lord is saying, sarva-bhuteshu kuntiya sambhamanti murtayoja tasam mahajjani brahma aham bijapadapita. My dear Arjuna, whatever forms of life you are seeing, there are 84 lakh species of life. That means 8 million and 400,000 of different varieties of life. Not 1, 2, 3 or 1,000, 3,000, no. We have not seen. Even the biologist or the anthropologist, they cannot calculate. But from authoritative living teacher, we get this information that there are 8,400,000 subspecies of life, of which human beings, they are divided into 400,000 species of life. And 8 million, there are other species of life. But Krishna, the Supreme Lord, claims that all of them, never mind, either he is bird or beast or man or a snake or whatever, he god, a semi-god, demigod, anything, whatever, there are different forms. But apart from the forms, real identity is that all of them, they are my sons. I am actually Bijapada Pita, seed-giving father. Just like this father gives the seed, and the mother receives the seed, and the body is formed according to the mother's body. And when the body is completely formed, it comes out. Either from cats, either from dog, either from man or anything. That is the process of generation. The father gives the seed and it takes emulsified two kinds of secretion within the womb of the mother, and in the first night the body is formed like a pea, then gradually it develops. There are certain holes, the 9 holes, they first of all come out. 9 holes, we have got 9 holes. 2 eyes, 1 mouth, 2 ears, and penis, and so many things. So, when they are fully developed, they come out. And according to their last karma or action, they get this body and enjoy or suffer. That is the process of birth and death, it is going. And after finishing this life, again dies, again enters into the womb of the mother, again gets another type of body, again comes out. This is going on. So we should be very much intelligent that how long we shall continue this repetition of birth and death and change of body. Any intelligent man. That is the prerogative of the human form of life. That is the prerogative. He can stop this process, repetition of birth and death. He can get his real, actual, spiritual form again and be blissful, full knowledge and eternal life. That is the whole process. So we should not miss this. And the whole thing begins just what we have begun now. Now, this chanting and hearing. I wanted to point out that this chanting and hearing is as good as actual association of Krishna. That is stated in the Bhagavad, that Srinatam Sakatam Krishna Punna Savana Kirtana. This process is called Kirtana. Even one does not understand the language, still by hearing only, he acquired some piety. His assets become pious life. Even he does not understand, it is such power. The Srinatam Sakatam Krishna Krishna Katha means topics in the matter of Krishna. The topics in the matter of Krishna, there are two kinds of topics. One topic is this Bhagavad Gita. It is spoken by Krishna. And another Krishna Katha, I mean the topics about Krishna is this Srimad Bhagavatam. That is spoken about Krishna. So there are two types of Krishna Katha, and both of them are equally potent because it is connected with Krishna. Now in the Bhagavad Gita, we find that the Bhagavad Gita is spoken in the battlefield of Kurukshetra. Now what we have to do with the battlefield? We have nothing to do with battlefield. We are here to have some knowledge in the spiritual atmosphere. And why should we bother about the battlefield? No. Because in the battlefield, the whole battlefield has become Krishnaized. As Krishnaized. Just like if the electric charges, current is in some matter, the whole thing becomes a charge of electricity. Similarly, when Krishna is interested in some matter, then the whole thing becomes Krishnaized. Otherwise, there was no need of discussing the battlefield of Kurukshetra. So that is the omnipotence. Now this omnipotency is described in Srimad Bhagavatam. Simnatam sagata krishna punna samana kirtana riddantasta avadrani vidhunoti suhit satam. Now, simply by hearing the Krishna Katha, that means, Krishna Katha means this. Krishna Katha, there are many, all the Vedic literatures, they are full of Krishna Katha. And all the Vedas means, that is also Krishna Katha. Any scripture and Veda that may appear apparently different, but they are meant for Krishna Katha. Krishna Katha, because you will find in the Bhagavad Gita, the Veda is tasadvai ahameva vedam. The whole topics, they are meant for Krishna Katha. You will excuse me, I am born with nature, I say. So, Krishna Katha, Simnatangsi Krishna Katha, if you kindly, simply hear about these Krishna Katha topics on Krishna, then what will be the result? Because it is pure transcendental vibration, the result will be Simnatang Sakatha Krishna Punnasamana Riddantasta Avadrani. We have accumulated many inauspicious things within our heart due to our material contamination for many births, not only this birth, but many last birth. So, when we surcharge our heart with the Krishna Katha, then the result will be Sinnatang Sakata Krishna Punnasmana Riddhantastha. Riddhantastha means the contamination which we have accumulated within our heart, that will be washed off. That will be washed off. So that your heart will be cleansed of all rubbish things. And as soon as all rubbish things are cleared up, then we are situated in pure consciousness. Because it is very difficult to understand, to eradicate oneself from all the designations. Suppose I am Indian. Is it very easy? Is it not very easy to take it for granted immediately that I am not Indian? I am pure soul. Similarly, anyone not identify with this bodily designation, it is not very easy. task. But still, if we go on hearing the Krishna Katha as you have begun here, it will be very easy. It will be very easy. You make an experiment. You make an experiment how easily you shall be able to get yourself free from all these designations. And as soon as we are free from the designation, now what are the freedom, what are the signs of freedom? The signs of freedom, sinnatāṁ sukatā krishna punna savana kītana riddhanta stavadrāni vidhunati śrīdhṣitāṁ nashta prāyeshu avadreshu nashta prāyeshu avadreshu nittaṁ bhāgavata śrīvaya. Bhakti bhagavati bhakti bhagavati naishthaki bhavati naishthaki. Now, as soon as not 10% clearance, it is not possible to clear our, rubbish things within our mind all of a sudden or very soon, all things, and even some percentage of the rubbish are cleared off, then at once it happens that the influence of the material nature becomes slackened. Tatorajastamo bhava kamalo bhagarashtade cheta etai ranavidhya sthita satya prasidati. And the material nature is working in three modes: goodness, passion and ignorance. Now, ignorance is hopeless life. Passion is too much materialistic. Passion means one who is influenced by the modes of passion, he wants this false enjoyment. Although, because he does not know, he wants to squeeze out the energy of the body to enjoy this matter. That is called modes of passion. And modes of ignorance, they are neither passion nor goodness, in the most darkness of life. And modes of goodness is that in that position we can understand at least theoretically what I am. So, by hearing Krishna Katha, you will be freed from the two stages of ignorance and passion. He'll be situated in the modes of goodness. At least we'll have the real knowledge, what I am. Because in the ignorance, just like animals. Animals, you see, the animals' life is full of suffering. But still, the animal does not know that he is in suffering. Take the case of a hog. Of course, here in your New York City, no a hog is seen. But and in village, in India, not only village and sometimes in towns, we see the hog. Oh, how much miserable life there, living in a filthy place, eating stools, and all is unclean, and anyone sees hog and nasty. But the hog does not know that he is in nasty condition. He is very jolly. He is very jolly. The person who is in the upper status of life, he can see that, oh, this is very nasty life. Sannatāṁ sakatā krishna punnasamana kītana riddhantasya vadrāni vidhūnati suhissatāṁ nastaprāyaśa vadreṣu. Nittam bhagavata sivaya, nittam, daily, as a routine work. If you hear this Krishna katha, then the result will be that nashta prayeshu avadreshu, when all this accumulation of dirty things in our heart accumulated for life after life, they will be cleared up. And as a matter of evidence, you'll see that you are not no more in ignorance and in passion, but you are situated in the modes of goodness. Then what is that position? Cheto eti ranavidhya. Then your mind will not be attacked by the modes of ignorance and passion. You'll be steadily fixed up in the position of goodness. Then when you are in goodness, then what is your attitude? Prasanna manaso. You will find yourself joyful in every circumstances of life. You'll never feel yourself morose. In the Bhagavad Gita you'll find that is our Brahma Bhuta situation. The Vedas teaches us that you are not this matter. You are Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi. Lord Shankaracharya, he preach this gospel to the world that we are not this matter, we are Brahma, spirit soul. So that when that spiritual realization will be actually done, then your symptoms will change. What are those symptoms? The Brahma Bhuta Prasanna Atma Nasochati Natankati. When one is situated in his own spiritual consciousness, then he will have no hankering and no lamentation. Lamentation for loss or hankering for gain. Two things are going on in this material world. The things which we do not possess, we hanker after it. If I get these things, I will be happy. If I get this, I have no money. If I get 100,000 million dollars, then I will be happy. This is hankering. And when 100,000 million dollars you have got somewhere or other, it is lost. You cry. I am gone. So either for earning or we hanker, that is also a kind of distress. And when you suffer loss, there is distress. But if you are situated in Brahma-bhuta avastha, you will be neither distressed nor hankering. You will be in equilibrium. Jasmin sthite guru napi dukkhena na vichalate. Even if you are situated in the midst of fiery tribulation, you will not be disturbed. That is the position. The evang prasanna manaso bhagavad bhakti yogataha bhagavat tattva vijnanam mukta sangas jayate. So bhagavat tattva vijnan means the science of God. The science of God becomes perceivable by such person who is situated in the Brahma Bhuta the status. But from that Brahma Bhuta status, we have to work. And that work is recommended here. Buddhi yukto jahatiya ubhe sukrite duskite tasmat jugaya jujjasa juga karmasu kausalam. So long we have got this material body. We have to work. We cannot stop working. That is not possible. But we have to adopt the tactics of yoga. So that even by doing ordinary work in which by destiny or by circumstances I am put into, there is no harm. You will find in Bhagavad Gita that even if you find in your own occupation, suppose I am occupied in some business in which I have to speak lie. Without speaking lie, my business cannot go on. Now suppose if that is the position. Now speaking lie is not very good thing, but if you think that your business is not very based on very moral principles, so I should give up. Then Bhagavad Gita will find that don't give up. Even if you are put into such circumstances that your livelihood cannot go on without that unfair means, still you should not give it up. But you should try to make it purified. You should try to make it purified. How it is purified? Now, you should not take the fruitive result of your work. That is meant for God. So here it is stated that buddhi yukto jahatiha ubhe sukrita duskrita. Sukrita means pious activities, and duskrita means impious activities. In the material platform, we have two things, pious or impious. Pious or impious. Either you are doing some pious activities, or you are doing some impious activities, or you are doing mixed pious or impious. So Lord Krishna advises that if you act with intelligence or devotion of the Supreme, intelligence means, what is that intelligence? That I am the part and parcel of the Supreme Consciousness, pure soul, I am not this body. This is called intelligence. If you identify yourself, I am American, I am Indian, I am this or that, then you are material plane. If you identify yourself that I am neither American nor Indian, but I am pure consciousness, I am subordinate consciousness of the Supreme Consciousness, or in other words, I am servant of God. God is Supreme Consciousness, and I am subordinate. But so, for our present understanding, a subordinate means a servant. But don't carry out the idea of servant in relation to God. Yeah, nobody wants to be servant. Everyone wants to be master. Because to become servant is very palatable thing. But to become servant of God is not exactly like this. Sometimes servant of God becomes the master of God. The real position of the living entity is the servant of God. But in Bhagavad Gita I see that the master Krishna has become the servant of Arjuna. Arjuna is sitting on the chariot, and Krishna has accepted his driver-ship. He is not the servant of the owner of the chariot. So, in spiritual relation, we should not carry out the conception of this material relationship. Although the relationship are there, the whole relationship, as you have got experience in this world, the same relationship are there in the spiritual world. But that relationship is not contaminated with matter. Therefore they are pure and transcendental. Therefore they are of a different nature. As we become advanced in spiritual conception of life, then we can understand what is the actual position in spiritual transcendental life. So here, the Lord instructs that buddhi yukta. Buddhi yukta means with the full consciousness that you are not this body. If we act in that way, now if I am not body, then I am consciousness, that is a fact. Now, if we act on the consciousness platform, then we can overcome the fruitive result of good work or bad work. It is transcendental stage. It is transcendental stage. It is specially mentioned, buddhi yukta jahatiya sukrita duskrita. That means you are acting on other's account, on the supreme account. You are not liable for loss or gain. When there is gain, don't be puffed up. You should think that this gain is for Lord, and when there is loss, you should know that this is not my responsibility, it is God's work, He will see. Then you'll be happy. That practice we have to do. Everything on account of the Supreme. That transcendental nature we have to develop. Tasmat yoga yujasya yoga karnasu kumsalam. This is the trick of doing work in this present circumstances. As soon as we work on the platform of bodily consciousness, we become bound up by the reaction of my work. And as soon as I work on spiritual consciousness, I am not bound up either by sukriti or duskriti, either by pious activities or by, vicious activities. That is the technique. Karmajang buddhijoktahi phalam takta manishina. Manishina, this word is very significant. Manishina means thoughtful. Manisha means thought. Manishina, those who have got, those who are thoughtful, not trifle, those who are thoughtful. Unless one is thoughtful, one cannot understand that he is not this body. Then how you can do work for yourself? Now what is your position? Now I am consciousness. But what kind of consciousness? Subordinate consciousness. I am the part of the Supreme Consciousness. Then what is your activity? My activity will be under the guidance of the Supreme Consciousness. Just like in an office, the managing director is the Supreme Consciousness. Just for example. Now everyone is working under him, under his direction. So anyone who is working under his direction, they have no responsibility. They have got simply to discharge duty, either pious or impious, never mind. In military rank, the order of the captain or the commander is there. The soldier has to execute it. Never mind whether it is pious or impious, it doesn't matter. He has to act simply. Then he becomes real soldier. If he acts in that way, he gets remuneration, he gets reward, he gets title, he gets honor. He doesn't care. The commander asks him, just go and kill the enemy. He goes and kills. He gets reward. But killing, do you mean to say by killing one gets reward? No. For the duty discharge. Similarly, here the whole position is that Krishna is instructing Arjuna. Krishna is the Supreme Consciousness. And Krishna has to discharge only according to the order of this Supreme Consciousness. So mind. Manishina means those who are thoughtful, philosopher, those who can take up things by philosophical conclusion, that I am consciousness, I am the part and parcel of the Supreme Consciousness. Therefore my duty is to act according to the Supreme Consciousness. Just like your hand is the part of your body. Now, it is moving according to my consciousness. The hand is not moving in its own way. As I want, let the hands be moved, let my legs be moved, let my eye be opened and see. So I am dictating and these parts are working. Similarly, we are all parts and parcel of the Supreme Consciousness. When we train ourselves to move and act in according to that Supreme Consciousness, then we become transcendental to all these pious or impious activities. That is the technique. The karmajam buddhi yukta hi phalam takta manishina. Manishina means thoughtful. Those who are thoughtful, those who have understood that I am the part and parcel of the Supreme Consciousness, and let me act in that way. Then what will be the result? Just see. The fine result. Janma bandha vinam mukta padam gacchanti anamayam. Then he becomes free from the bondage of birth and death. no more birth and death. Janma bandhan. This is a very strong, subtle, you see. Janma mitya jara vyadhi. Modern scientists, modern philosophers, they do not think about these four things. Janma mitya jara vyadhi. Birth, death, disease and old age. They set them aside. Oh, let them be happy. Let us enjoy this life. Hugs and dogs. This is not human life. Human life is meant to make a solution of this bondage. Life, I mean birth, death, disease and old age. If the human civilization has not made a solution of these four things, that is not human civilization. Human civilization is meant for making a complete solution of these things. So here, in the Bhagavad Gita, just see how the Lord says, the karmajang buddhijuktahi. Karmajang. Karmajang means whenever you act, there will be some reaction. If you act good things, there will be good reaction. If you act bad things, there will be bad reaction. But reaction, either good or bad, that is in higher sense, all suffering. I have already explained to you some other day. Now suppose by good action I get good birth, good riches, and good features of the body, good education, all these things I get. But that does not mean that I am free from the material pangs. The material pangs are janma mitya jara vyadhi, birth, death, old age and diseases. Because you are rich man, because you are beautiful man, because you are educated man, because you are born in an aristocratic family, that does not mean that you have avoided death, old age and disease. So we shall not be concerned with pious activities or impious activities. We shall be concerned with transcendental activities. That will save me from this bondage of birth, death, old age and disease. That should be our aim of life. We should not be hankering after good or bad things, because everything here in higher consciousness, everything material. Now take for example, suppose you are diseased, suffering from some disease, you are lying on the bed and you are eating in that stage, you are passing your nature's call in that way and taking bitter medicines, and always you have to keep by the nurses clean, otherwise there is some obnoxious smell. In such a condition you are lying, and some friends come to you and ask you, my dear such and such, how are you today feeling? Yes, I am today feeling well. What is this well? He is lying on the bed, he is passing his nature's course in that way, he is eating bitter medicine and he cannot move, all these inconveniences, and he says that I am well. Similarly, in our material concept of life, if we think I am happy, that is foolishness. That is foolishness. There is no happiness in material life. It is impossible to get happiness. Then we do not know meaning of happiness. Therefore, this very word is huge, manishina. We want to happy to become by some extraneous, artificial means. And how long it will stand? It will not stand. It will again come back. Suppose by intoxication you feel happy. That is not your actual happiness. Suppose by chloroform, I am unconscious, I don't feel the pains of operation. That does not mean that I am out of these pains and pleasures. This is artificial. So real pleasure, real life is here. As recommended in Bhagavad Gita by Sri Krishna, just see. karmajam buddhijuktahi phalanatakta manishina. Manishina means the thoughtful. They give up the reaction of work, being situated in the platform of consciousness, and the result will be the janmabandham vinirmukta. This bondage of birth and death and disease and old age, he becomes free from that. Then the next life, padam gacchanti anamayam. Anamayam. Anamayam means where there is no death, no the old age, no birth, no disease. That's possible. That is called Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha. The Sanskrit word is Vaikuntha. Vaikuntha means Bhagata Kuntha. Kuntha means anxiety. Anxiety. Here, due to our material contamination, we are always full of Kuntha, anxiety. In the world, when he is eating, he is thinking like this, this way, this way, this way. Somebody is coming, kill me. Full of anxiety. We are also anxious. The politician is anxious. So long we are in contamination of these material body, we must be anxious. Imagine answers. There is a nice instruction by Prahlad Maharaj, a great devotee, a boy devotee. And he was from his boyhood, childhood, from his mother's womb, he became a devotee by the grace of Narada Muni. That is history. Now, he was 5 years old boy, and his father was too much materialistic. And he wanted that his son should be great politician, economist, and so on, just like the materialists want. But the boy is a devotee. So father did not like the idea. So one day he called his boy, my dear boy, come on. He came, small boy, sit down on my lap. All right, my dear boy, will you kindly tell me what you have learned, the best thing in your school? Yes, my dear father, I shall tell you. So he says like this, tatsadu manne suravajya dihinam sada samudh bhigna dhyam asad grahat hitya atma ghatam grihyanda kupam vanangato jad harima srayita. My dear father, he is addressing his father, oh, the best amongst the materialists. Now, he is not afraid. His father was very powerful. And there is a story we shall narrate one day. Now today is shortly I am giving some instance. So he says, my dear father, you are the greatest of the materialists. But to my opinion, that is the best thing. If people should give up this materialistic life and devote himself for searching out God, then he will be free from the anxieties which is due to him, due to his material connection. Just how seasonal. But hitya tasad manne suravarja dekhna sada samudh vigna dhiyam. Persons who are always full of anxieties. Why? Not due to their material connection. Asat. Asat means matter. Matter will not stay. However, you may chemically try to preserve it, it will not stay. Therefore, it matters. Another name is Asat. And spirits, another name is Sat. Sat means which exists. Asat means which does not exist. Antamattini diha nittasokta sarivina. We have already described that this body is antavat, it has got end. But the consciousness of the spirit soul, it is not, it is endless. So the endless, I mean to say ever existent soul being contaminated by this body is full of anxiety. So Prahlad Maharaj thinks that in order to realize his self for self-realization, if he gives up all material engagement and takes to the path of self-realization, that is the best way of his life. And the father became angry, what nonsense he's taking. A 5 years old boy is talking of self-realization. I wanted to make him a great politician, economist. Now he's talking of this nonsense. And ityatmabhatam brihandakupam. He's describing that this family life is just like a dark well. Whatever you want, that doesn't matter. But act it on the platform of consciousness. And that platform, acting on the consciousness, is Lord Chaitanya has made very easy. Just like there are some note makers of the school books, easy study. So Lord Chaitanya has recommended that you may be engaged in whatever occupation that may be, good or bad, you don't mind for that. But you must hear the Krishna Katha. You must continue to hear this Bhagavad Gita. That is, for this we are trying to organize this institution. That you come, whatever you do, that doesn't matter. Everything will be adjusted by and by. Because, as I have described in the beginning, the Simmatam Savata Krishna Vidvantas Avadhyam, everything will be adjusted as our mind becomes clear, 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 simply by hearing. Simply by